My name is Savyasachi Thakkar. I'm an orthopedic surgeon at Johns Hopkins. I specialize in hip and knee reconstruction. I work at the Howard County General Hospital. Hip replacements can be done with several different approaches. At Johns Hopkins Orthopedics, we typically use minimally invasive, patient-centered approaches to try and achieve the best possible outcome in a hip replacement surgery. The hip can be approached from the front, which is known as the anterior approach, from the side, which is known as the anterolateral or lateral approach, and then from the back, which is known as a posterolateral approach. The advantages of an anterior approach is that it is minimally invasive and involves a muscle-sparing approach so that we do not damage any muscles while accessing the hip joint, which is naturally positioned more towards the front or anteriorly. The lateral approach is also a minimally invasive approach, which involves going through the outside of the hip so that we're away from the vasculature or the blood vessels to the hip. The posterolateral approach is the third minimally invasive approach to the hip. The utility of this approach is that it can be used to perform simple hip replacement surgeries and can also be extensile, which means we can make the incision larger if we need to do a revision hip replacement surgery. A hip replacement surgery typically involves addressing the ball and the socket part of the hip. The socket is more in the pelvis and the ball is in the hip bone. We typically try and remove the arthritic ball and smooth out the arthritic socket to put in metal, plastic, and ceramic pieces which comprise the new hip joint. So a hip replacement comprises of a metal shell that goes into the pelvis along with a very high grade polyethylene or plastic liner. We then have a ceramic ball that fits into a metal part that goes into the thigh bone. And once the ceramic fits into the plastic, that becomes a brand new hip replacement. There are occasions when a hip replacement or knee replacement fails, or there's a need for conversion from a partial knee replacement to a total knee replacement. That is known as a revision joint replacement procedure. At Johns Hopkins Orthopedics, we specialize in evaluating causes of failure, whether it's related to the implant, whether it's related to the technique, or an amalgamation of both, and providing our honest opinion to patients so that we may perform revision procedures to ensure a healthy, active lifestyle.